Most people, if they're exposed to the virus, will have symptoms start to develop after about 5 days after that exposure. Now, some people it may be longer, and some people it may be shorter, right? For some people it may be even a day or two. And there are some people who might go out as far as 12 to even 13 days before symptoms start up. This is one of the reasons why you've heard the 14-day quarantine period bandied about. Fever and cough tend to be the two most common symptoms that we see initially right up front. Some people might have some other symptoms, general myalgias, muscle aches, as we say, pains, feeling just run down and very tired. Those are pretty common. Some people may have some gastrointestinal symptoms, although that's a minority, probably less than 10% might have nausea, abdominal pain, or even diarrhea. The shortness of breath, which of course is the one that we're most worried about. If they do develop that, it's typically about 5 days or so after the symptoms develop in the first place. And so that's when we might see a lot of people showing up in the hospitals, of course, when they're having the trouble with their breathing. Now, for most people, that's still fairly minor. The most important thing for those people who otherwise may be younger and healthier, who may have the disease, is to self-quarantine, right? Try to prevent yourself from giving it to other people by staying home, by practicing some of this social distancing that we talk about, right? And making sure other people are aware that you might be sick and distance themselves from you, right? Lots of hand sanitizer, cleaning those hands, cleaning the environment, practicing nice cough etiquette, right? Coughing into the elbow. And if, of course, you do start to feel worse, and particularly start having trouble with breathing, then please, come to the hospital so we can help you.